Welcome to the Charming School Show, your weekly lesson in all things lifestyle and relationships. I'm Kim.
And I'm Krystal. And today, wait a minute. What? Before we even get into this subject, let's remind the people that they need to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. They need to follow us on Instagram at The Charm School Show and on Facebook, The Charm School Show. And make sure you share and that you like and that you comment and you do all those things.
Tag a friend.
Yes, tag a friend. We appreciate it. We appreciate all y'all's support thus far. Now we can get into what we're talking about. What are we talking about today, Kim?
Today we're gonna talk about growing up in the black church.
Cause
we got some stories to tell y'all.
Yes, cause we grew up in the black church. And obviously,
right.
So,
As colored girls,
growing up in that good old church house. Mm-hmm. So you guys can probably relate to these things that we're talking about. And if we miss something that y'all think about, make sure that you comment below and let us know.
Yes, absolutely. Let's get into this.
All right.
So first things first, let's talk about, I'm about to go first things first, our Papa.
Right, and that's what was in my mind.
Sorry, Lord.
Sorry, Jesus.
That's
we're
not.
We're supposed to be talking about church today.
On today. So first things I want to jump into is the fashion.
Girl.
Can you remember, it's not the come as you are as today.
No.
Where you can go in skinny jeans and
right,
whatever.
Right, and a hoodie. And like right now, I could go to church and feel relaxed. I ain't got to worry about it. But back in the day, if that skirt was not past your knees, if you did not have no stockings.
Ooh, don't talk about the white, oh, the white stockings.
The white stockings.
Big white stockings.
Child, you better not go in there. The mother of the church will come and lay some over your knees.
I used to be so embarrassed for girls when they get the little handkerchief over their knees.
Right, you're like, ooh, see, she knew better before she walked out the house.
She shouldn't have did that.
Right? Wait a minute, Kim. You did not go to a black church if you weren't in church all day.
All day.
Let alone all day. What about all week?
There's always something.
It's always something. So Sunday, you got Sunday school. Mm-hmm. And my mama was a Sunday school teacher. So we were there before Sunday school. And then Sunday school. And then you had regular church service. Mm-hmm. And then y'all may have had some refreshments or something afterwards for whatever reason. Somebody's selling something for somebody. Mm-hmm. The building fund or something.
The prison ministry needs selling plates.
Yeah, they selling plates after church. So you got to linger around after that. Mm-hmm. And then you gotta go to evening service.
Right. Oh my gosh. For me, it was like an all day affair. Because first of all, my pastor was already long-winded.
Child.
Long-winded as, I was about to say his hand.
Hold on. Wait a minute, Kim.
So you know one of my favorite parts of going to church was?
Oh Lord.
Testimony service.
Child.
As a kid.
Why do you keep saying child? Because that's how they talk in church. Go ahead.
As a kid, that was my favorite part because I'm like, you never know what's going to happen. Somebody going to get up there and tell all their business.
Right.
Cry, start shouting. It was like TV for me. I was like.
But sometimes testimony service got too long.
It got way too long.
Because you know it's going to be that one person that has that crazy story. They're going to be up there and then they just need to be tapped on the shoulder to say 2 minutes.
Wrap it up. They've been waiting all week though to put this out and get this off their chest.
So one of my favorite parts of church growing up and still today is choir and or praise team.
Yes!
Like it is like the hype. Before the hype, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And as a kid, it was the part that I just wanted to add. As soon as the choir was done, I was like, all right, can we go?
Right, you know, I came for. That's all I wanted.
But like being in the choir and part of the choir, so, like that was like one of the best parts. Like it really does like usher in the spirit.
Right, and to me, black churches, they choirs be lit. It's different.
Lit.
Cause you gonna have a little dance. You gonna have a performance with it and it's really gonna draw you in. Like my choir used to cut up sometimes at GFGT and I'll be like, yes, spirit.
Right. Or if it wasn't rocking, then it's like kind of a little funny. Somebody get up there and they don't know the words, they all off pitch. And
wait,
you're just like, child.
Don't you have a story about not knowing the words?
I don't have that story.
For a Christmas.
I'm not, don't do me.
Okay, I thought you had messed up. But I bet you they all said, sing for Jesus.
So I did mess up one Christmas. And I forgot. words. But I was doing it for the master. I was trying to sing for the Lord.
Yeah. You didn't have to tell the people that.
I'm sorry.
That's why you were. See, you know what? You banned from testimony service because you was trying to get my testimony and it ain't church.
You deliver.
Next topic. The programs.
The programs.
So there's always a program. And one of the best ones is Easter programs.
Easter. Jesus swept.
He did it.
I love showing that older kids who don't remember or don't want
to
do it.
Did you used to remember your speech?
I never had a speech. I was too shy. I didn't do it. I wasn't doing it.
What?
I was too scared. I bet y'all wouldn't believe it now, but yeah.
I wouldn't believe it. Couldn't have told me that before. Listen, I had to do a speech every time. And another thing is always getting up in front of, even because I told you my mom was a Sunday school teacher.
Mm-hmm.
So she would make me always give the review of the lesson every Sunday morning. So doing speeches wasn't that bad for me, except for the memorizing part. But it was always a struggle. But I think it is the cutest thing now that I'm an adult.
Mm-hmm.
If we ever did. They don't really do that as much anymore.
They don't, except at smaller black churches. But like my babies have gotten up and had to do speeches.
Okay, yeah.
They grandma run the program.
So they
get the good lines.
But there's always a program at church. Like that's mm-hmm. what keeps church being so long in the black church. Because you got to have a building fund program, an usher program, a
missionary.
Everybody got a program. The kids Sunday. You know, it's always something.
And I'm hungry.
At the end of the day, I'm always hungry in church. Church just make you hungry. Gotta go get some churches.
You don't want that fried rat.
Oh, this is your favorite part. We should be hearing all the praise because it's time for offering.
Give, it shall be given.
Oh, is that what y'all used to sing?
Yeah, they sing it at Fifth Street, I thought.
No, they don't sing that at Fifth Street.
They sing it somewhere. It shall be given. Unto ye.
We didn't sing that at Fifth Street.
Krystal.
We used
somebody
to sing.
Sang that.
Oh, give thanks.
Oh, that was it.
He is good. Yes, he is good.
That was it. You're right.
Yeah, Pastor Coleman. There's a shout out, Pastor Coleman. Fifth Street Missionary Baptist Church.
I visited.
But offering was like so like the hype time, but like. Let me go
to the bathroom real quick.
Well, we remember in church, it used to be like 5 offerings in one service.
Oh my gosh, so if you went to Sunday school, there's a Sunday school basket, regular service basket, and then at the end of regular service, there's another basket. Now, wait a minute, I done gave you every, how am I gonna get home now?
I can't get gas. And now I can't go to Golden Corral. That took off my Golden Corral money.
Every quarter. Okay, so this video would not be complete without us talking about, of course, Pastor, First Lady.
I like saying like a slave.
I joked. Because that's where the church originated.
Now, that's the truth.
And it's Black History Month. But no, I think it is. I loved how dramatic preaching is in the black church.
Very
like,
dramatic.
The rises and the falls and the and have your little patch of hands.
You better have your handkerchief and be waving it and yeah. I mean, all the theatrics.
Right.
I mean, that's when you, well, then you also knew that church was almost over. That's how you knew the sermon was wrapping up because he started doing his huffing and puffing and all that. And I think, like, that is the symbol. That's the overall symbol of you in a black church.
I remember once my pastor would get, he thought he was James Brown because he'd have all the robes. And then he had a woman who would come, a nurse, would come and put the other robe on top. One time he threw that robe off. We said, all right, James Brown, you about to do the splits too?
He probably would have if he could.
I loved it.
All the theatrics. And then let's not forget First Lady.
Mm-hmm.
First Lady gonna come and represent for her man.
Right.
Every time she gonna have on the big hat. And they gonna be matching.
Oh gosh.
Don't let me a theme Sunday.
Pastor and wife gonna be matching.
My robe is gonna coordinate with your pantyhose, baby.
Yes.
That's just how that's gonna be.
A pastor and wife anniversary service.
Ooh, that's when they really show out. Absolutely.
Like, could you be a pastor's wife?
Well, you see, I'm not. So I was supposed to be.
Oh, I forgot.
Thanks, Chris. We gotta end the show. We got to exit the show the right way.
Exit the show. Are you still gonna be my friend?
In the name of Jesus, we ask that you heal this relationship.
Yes, Lord. We need your healing power
to shine down on us. We also need you guys to make sure that you are like, commenting, and subscribing.
Yes.
Tell us about your experiences in the Black church. We want to hear them.
Because
we know we're not the only ones.
We do. Tell us your favorite part.
Tell us your testimonies.
Yeah. Record a testimony service.
And drop it.
Thank you guys for watching.
Yes.
We'll see you next time.